Before we go on with lesson two, there's something that every blues player either already knows or should know, and that is that you remember in lesson one how we played a 12-bar blues. And we used a... C minor blues scale over the top of those chords, or with those chords. Well, you can use a minor pentatonic, which is three semitones below that. So that means that you can use a minor pentatonic starting on A. So the tab for that is 5/8, 5/7, 5/7, 5/7, 5/8, 5. So 5/8, 5/7, 5/7, 5/7. 5/8/5. And that scale works just fine with exactly the same chord progression. So everybody kind of knows that. Now that the scale can have some extra notes added into it, of course. So we can use the hammer-ons, trills, pull-offs, slides, all those things like we... like we looked at in the last lesson. So I thought to start today's lesson we could just go through that chord progression, but this time incorporating with that some notes from the A minor pentatonic scale. Here's the F chord, bar 5. Turns round with a G. Okay, so that A minor pentatonic scale works just fine when you're playing a blues in C. So the second part of this lesson then is about chord substitution. And we often use four techniques when we use chord substitution. Now I should say that when we use these chords, Larry Coryell talks about them in his book called Jazz Guitar. But these chords are used not just in jazz, they're used in all styles of music, and they're often based on the classical harmony, which goes back to the European classical composers, to Bach and people like the Italian composer Puccini, Erik Satie, French composer, and then in the 20th century people like George Gershwin and Duke Ellington. Chord-based patterns connected together by smooth-sounding chord progressions. So there's really four forms of chord substitution, and those four types are chord extensions, moving by bass line, approaching chords from a semitone below, or a semitone above, and also using turnarounds. Okay, so chord extensions, first of all, these occur when you just take the basic chord and you add some extra notes to it. So you may be familiar, of course, with a C chord, a C7th, a C6th, C9th, and this kind of thing. But in our blues pattern, we were using a C seventh chord. Now, if you take the notes in that chord, which is C, E, B flat, and C, if you go C, E, B flat, and instead of playing the C, you play the note which is a third above the B flat, that gives you C, E, B flat, D, and that gives you a new chord, and that's called C ninth. Now, you put another third above that, above the D, you get the note F. And that gives you then a new chord called C11th, or like that. Now, it's hard for us to play all those notes on the guitar at the same time, so often we need to simplify the chord down a little bit. In this case, we turn that chord into a four-note chord with only four notes in it. C, obviously, B-flat, D, and F. We'll call that C11th. But Larry Coryell in his book calls it C9 sus 4. Both of those names are fairly complicated. There's another way that you can look at that chord, and that's just to call it a B-flat chord, B-flat D-F, with a C in the bass. So that's quite a cool sounding chord. Got a nice sound, and it's used a lot in contemporary music. Okay, so that's the first thing, which is the chord extension. The next one is when you connect chords together by using a bass line. So with this one here, say we're using a C7th chord, you can then use the other notes in the chord to move. So you might have a C chord here, put the E in the bass, and that would then move smoothly to an F chord. So there's the C chord, goes to an E in the bass, and here's the F chord. Now likewise, if you were going from an F chord, F7th, say through to G minor 7th, you could connect those two chords together by going through the note F sharp. There's that chord progression, bass line. It would become... So you can see it's got a smooth sound connecting two chords together. So we can use a bass line to connect two chords together. Say we were going from G minor through to C7th. We could go G minor, A minor 6th, F sharp over A sharp, G over B up to C. So that would give us a bass line. So that'd be... So you can hear the bass line moving there. The third one is using a turnaround. A turnaround is really just like in the last two bars of the blues, we were using C and G. When we repeat the pattern to get back into C again on the first bar, a turnaround could be just a C, A minor, for example, an F, and a G. Like the Stand By Me chord progression. But there's lots of turnarounds, there's lots of ways you can do the same kind of thing. So turnarounds, another way of connecting chords together. The final one is you can approach any chord from a semitone above or below. Now that's obviously you can do things like just sliding to the chord. Or sliding down. But you can actually hold the chord. You don't have to just slide it, you can actually accent it. So... So if you're moving from C7th to F7th, you could connect that together by moving like that, or using some other connecting chord like... Thank you. Okay. So what I thought we could do today is then look at Larry Coryell's choice of chord substitutions for playing the blues. And he has two patterns with this. He starts with a C7th chord, then he moves to a C7th over E, moves to F7th, which we've done before, but then uses a connecting chord, an F-sharp diminished chord. For the C7th chord, he starts with a chord extension, which is G minor 7th. And then for the C7th chord, he uses another chord extension, C11th, I suppose we called it. Connecting chord, F-sharp diminished, moves down to F-sharp, F7th. He uses another connecting chord, F-sharp diminished, moves up to a C7th over G. An F7th, E minor 7 flat 5, and an A 7 sharp 5, D minor 7th. He approaches the G 7th through A 13th, down a semitone, and then walks the bass line up through through A sharp, and B, onto a really cool but kind of slightly out there chord progression based on B flat 13th, E flat 9th, A flat 13th, and D flat 9th. So I put that chord progression together in rhythm, we get something like this. Okay, so we put that together, we can combine we can combine the work that we do with the scales, the A minor pentatonic, with the chord substitutions that we've learned here, and we can mix them up sort of fairly freely. Like last week we did basically one bar of chords and then one bar of notes. We could do the same kind of thing here. We could play some chords, play some notes from the scale, go back to some chords again. This works great if you've got two guitars. We've got one guitar here now, so that's okay. If you're watching the video, you might want to play along and play some of the chords. And play some of the notes, of course. So there's the C7th. Thank you. this lesson covered the use of the minor pentatonic scale, which is three semitones below. And we had a brief look at chord substitution. You can do more this with this material than just copy it. The best thing to do with this is to play over it several times, many times, and see if you can continue to find new ways to apply these techniques and make new sounds every time you play. So remember, music is always best when we share it. So good luck, stay in the groove and make it sound good.